General, after the Wellington loss, you said the training intensity in the days leading up wasn't what you wanted. How has the training intensity been this week?
No, it didn't have anything to do with the intensity. It has to do with the focus, no concentration. So they were too relaxed, and we talked about it a few times last week. We seen some pictures, video, and yeah, we have to learn from it. And this is a new game, a new opponent. So hopefully we will pick up the good play we played against Victory. Even I can't say that everything was bad against Wellington, but overall it was too less to win the game.
Has that focus been better this week than it was last week from your boys?
Yeah, you hope so. The circumstances are all also different, because you lost now again a game, so they want to have revenge. So it will be different, and you can't compare it with last week. And this week I was satisfied about the training till now.
Two young of the young stars signing new deals yesterday, Toure, Dorigo. How good is that for you? How happy were you to lock them in for a couple more years here at Adelaide?
It's not up to me, because probably they will stay longer than I do. So it's my job. One of my goals is to get the youth teams, the youth players, be ready for the first team. That's why I also been this morning to the game from the youth team, to see how the guys are doing who are training with us. So I'm interested, and I want to develop the players, and so I can help Adelaide and help the young players. And I think we're doing a good job with the technical staff, the good environment. We work good together, and it's not only me, but also Gerald and Carl and Eugene. And then I forget also the physical trainer Django, and the medical ones, and Arvin, and Jay, and Stu, who's doing the data. And I think we're doing well. The boys are doing well. And this morning we won Melbourne City with 3-2, so it's looking good.
Excellent. On those two guys specifically, Toure, Dorigo, they've probably exceeded most expectations so far this year. How pleased have you been with, I guess, their form throughout the entire season?
Yeah, but sometimes you have to also be a little bit lucky, because it was a long time before we find a striker. So George was injured, so I had to do something, and yeah, I saw Toure playing in the youth team, and he was doing from the side, left or right wing. I think maybe can he also play as in the middle, and he can. And now he's a big competitor with Christian about to start as a starter. And Louis the same. We were a long time searching for a six. And the problem that I had is that Dorigo was in the preseason, almost 3 weeks, 4 weeks away with the national team under 20. So I didn't know what his capacity was, and how we will do it in the first quarter. So when he came back, yeah, I'm still searching for a six. Yeah. He's not the biggest one, not the strongest one, and I didn't know how smart he was and how he will do it in the first team. And then he gets a few minutes, several games, and then yeah, there were a lot of injuries. Boland was falling away, George was falling away again. So yeah, now not enough. James wasn't there, so he got his chance, and he did well till now. So. Because also sometimes as a young one, you have to be a little bit lucky. We have now a lot of attackers. Brooke, who I see also as an attacking midfield player or a striker on the right or left side. But he is a lot of competitors in front of him. because he's also a very talented boy, and he will also join the squad this game. He will be on the bench, so maybe he gets his minute also.
Riley McGree, he's hurt his knee. Have you got a replacement ready to go? I know you don't like necessarily telling us your squad or starters before the game, but is there someone you've got ready to step in?
I have to, otherwise we play with 10 men.
Are you confident though that you won't, get too out of sync with Riley out?
Yeah, Riley is a good player, and he's our top scorer. So you miss that kind of players. But what I said already, normally he had been away in January for the whole month, and because he got a punishment by the FFA, he's here. But now he's injured, and I think we find the solution. I've a lot of confidence that we still can beat our opponents.
Do you know how long Riley might be out for with his knee injury?
No, not exactly, but we are lucky that we have a weekend off, and I hope that after the weekend off he will be ready again, maybe one game later. We don't take any risk, but that's about the planning with him.
The last time you played Newcastle away, I think the first half was a pretty slow, sluggish performance by your team. You made some changes at half time and came out and won the match. How much do you think your team has improved since that last time you played Newcastle?
Yeah, we improved a lot, but also Newcastle. They won the last two games, so they have a lot of confidence. And they also known that in the first half they were the better team. It was very hot there. And the second half became good back in the game. It's a little bit strange, yeah, that we already played for the second time, or it was the FA Cup the third time against Newcastle, and some teams in the A-League we didn't compete till now. So that's a little bit strange, but. It's the same for Newcastle. They will now know how we play and how we do it, and we know how Newcastle is doing it, and it will be interesting how the guys are doing in this particular moment after the game from last week.
Dimitri Petratos, obviously the Newcastle playmaker, has been coming into good form in recent weeks. What's the key to stopping his impact?
No, I don't never talk about the players from the opponents. It's you can ask me everything about my own players, because I work the whole week with them, and I don't put a lot of energy in the players of the. They can have a bad day. There can be an injury. There can be a suspension, whatever. What it's up to us. We didn't. Of course, we lost Wellington. And Wellington played good football, but they also get an opportunity to get. Playing good football, because we were not there where we had to be, and we do some things we normally don't do. So that's the lesson. I think when we do the basic things very well, then we are difficult to stop, and we can win and beat every team. But if we don't do it, yeah, we can also lose from every team.
It's forecast 38 degrees. The weather tomorrow, the temperature. Have you ever coached in temperature that high?
Not often. Yeah, I think the summer sometimes in Holland is also be hot, but normally when it's so hot in Holland and when it's 38 degrees, we won't play. It will go to the afternoon or late in the evening, and we say okay, it's planned on 5 o'clock, but it's too hot and then at that time, so we play at 8. And we tried to change the time, but we weren't successful, because not only for the players but also for the defense to sit here. There's no roof, so no shadow. It will be very hot. It's a pity that more and more only the commercial thing about football is important and not the fans and the players. I think it's going all. The most important thing is the health of the players and the spectators, and I believe nobody is you know, they say there's no advantage for anybody to play so early, and I don't understand why they don't play a little bit later, 7 o'clock or 7:30. But I don't decide that.